According to the new yet ever-regressing YouTube community guidelines, if you want to watch a video about the gospel of Jesus Christ, or if you want an answer to a question about Christian theology, you need to be at least 18 years old. Earlier this year, YouTube removed one of my videos about the persecution of Christians in various countries. All I did in that video was report the latest statistics on the countries with the highest rates of persecution against Christians. YouTube removed the video as hate speech. Three separate YouTube reviewers all declared that my video reporting on the persecution of Christians was hate speech. My appeals were rejected, and I was banned from posting for a while. Fortunately, a bunch of people complained to @TeamYouTube on Twitter, and the video was ultimately restored. Apparently, while the YouTube Trust and Safety Team is concerned about people drawing attention to the persecution of Christians, they're even more concerned about people knowing where YouTube is heading with its policies. So my video was quietly restored. More recently, however, YouTube began adding age restrictions to Christian videos, even Christian videos that are simply answering questions about basic Christian theology. For instance, yesterday I received this message. Hi, Acts 17 Apologetics. As you may know, our community guidelines describe which content we allow and don't allow on YouTube. Your video, How Can God Die?, was flagged to us for review. Upon review, we've determined that it may not be suitable for all viewers, and it has been placed behind an age restriction. So now, if you're not signed into an adult's YouTube account and you click on the video, you'll see this. Sign in to confirm your age. This video may be inappropriate for some users. And you can see the notice. Age-restricted video, based on community guidelines. That video, of course, is simply a response to a common Muslim objection. Christians claim that Jesus is God. Christians also claim that Jesus died for sins. But that would mean that God died. How can God die? The answer, according to Christian theology, is that Jesus has two natures, a divine nature and a human nature. If you tell Muslims that, however, many of them will insist that it's absurd and illogical to claim that something divine can take on a physical nature. That's why, in my video, I point out that Muslims believe something very similar about the Quran. According to Islamic theology, the Quran is Allah's eternal speech. It has no beginning, it can't be corrupted, it can't be destroyed. But here in our physical world, Allah's speech takes on a physical nature made of paper and glue and ink. The physical book does have a beginning, it can be corrupted, it can be destroyed. Notice, if you were to destroy a physical Quran, you wouldn't say that the eternal speech of Allah has been destroyed. Likewise, if the God-man, Jesus Christ, dies on the cross, you wouldn't say that God has thereby been destroyed. The takeaway message is that if Muslims want to claim that God didn't enter creation as Jesus of Nazareth, they can claim that and present their evidence. But if they claim that it's somehow impossible or illogical or contradictory for God to enter creation as Jesus of Nazareth, they've just condemned their own theology of the Quran because a similar objection would apply. Why, in the name of common sense, would YouTube add an age restriction to such a simple point? Can you think of anyone who wouldn't want young people with questions about Christianity finding answers to their questions on YouTube? Can you think of anyone who would contact YouTube and say young people shouldn't be seeing Christians answering their questions about the gospel? I can. The disturbing part is that year after year, the trust and safety teams of YouTube and Facebook and Twitter become more and more obsessed with controlling what we can say and who can hear what we say, and with bringing the rules of what can and cannot be said more in line with their favorite ideologies. And the gradual shift always moves in one direction. It's slow, but relentless. It's now to the point where YouTube is age-restricting the gospel. If you're over 18 years old, congratulations. You're still free, for now, to hear someone respond to objections to the gospel on YouTube. So, while you still have this freedom, be sure to check out my video, How Can God Die? It's a response to one of the top three most common objections to Christianity you'll ever hear from Muslims. So why not take a few minutes to prepare a simple response to a question that's going to come up over and over and over again? As Louis Pasteur said, fortune favors the prepared mind.